We're here at first round. It's all done now. Kamloops, trying to get cleaned up here, but I'm here with the MX1 winner of the day, Christophe Porcel. Hey. Welcome to Canada. What a way to start the series and stuff. So maybe take us through both motos. Both motos seem good. I know you said you struggled a little bit with arm pump and, you know, kind of getting accustomed to new tracks and stuff, but yeah, what a way to come out.
It was good. You know, got the win, so that's the best thing of the day. But it was tough to get all the way here. We got flight cancellation on Friday, and they lost one of my bag and all that stuff. So we actually flew to Seattle instead of Vancouver, and then drive from Seattle to Vancouver and get a new car. Vancouver all the way here, so it was quite challenging. But we got everything now, and we got the win. So it was good. It's just you gotta learn very quick. Only two practice, and I don't know much about the tracks, especially this year. I was running backwards from last year, so you know, I didn't get much of, you know, the video footage from last year because it was completely different. But you gotta learn quick and find new lines, and you know, I don't know how much I'll be on water. You know, the first moto they overwater one of the corner, and it was was a murder in that corner. So it's just different organization, but it's more chill, I would say.
Yeah.
A lot of fun, but I like it also when it's really, really organized and I know what time is what. So it's just different. But first moto I got, I think I started 6 or 7, and went back all the way to, I think I was in third for a while, behind Medaglia, I think, yeah, I was right behind them, and then some guys came from the back, and they were a little bit faster. I got some bump up after about 15 minutes, so I was kind of struggling. I think we had some fork issue, did we?
But, we blew a fork seal, so that's why I started bottoming out. You're losing oil.
Yeah.
Fast.
So we had,
put new forks on.
The seal, they were leaking, so it wasn't helping.
Yeah.
But I was probably riding a little tight anyways, so it's just it's been a while. Two neck injury right before that, so that's like the first race back. So it's good. At least I can ride my bike and do my job and have fun. So it's just pretty amazing. Cause I wasn't sure I was gonna be able to ride anymore. So it's good to be here.
Well, I mean, you know, you've been through. I can't believe how, you know, resilient you are and stuff. You've been through, like you said, so many injuries, and you know, you've been at this sport a long time. And you know, I know from last year talking to Millsaps a little bit and stuff, you know, it's got to feel good, you know, whether it's Canada or, you know, GPs or US, it must feel good just to come up and like just win and like be the main guy that everyone is going to be chasing, you know, because it seems like when you're in the race in the States especially, it's just so stressed, and like, you know, everyone's separated by just a tiny little bit, but it must feel good just to come up and just go and win.
Yeah, I mean, for sure, it's winning is it always feels good. You know, you go to your local track, you win there. It's you know, that's why we started with, you know, we just we didn't have any money, or you know, you go race, you're not making any money, but you have a lot of fun, you ride with your friends, and that's why we. After all the neck injuries, that's what we've been trying to do, just go back home, and took about, I mean, 7 months off about,
yeah.
And you know, thank you to Bobby, because he, you know, my manager, he did let me do that, and we changed my program, because it was a little rough on the neck, so going to the therapy every day, and just trying to feel better, and like I said, I have a lot of fun, you know, just go ride with your friends, and
yeah.
Bicycles at the house, trails bike, all kinds of bikes. I try to enjoy it like I did when I was a kid. And, it's tough, you know, when you go and race the US and you're the top 10, and you know, 5 to 10 is good, but it's just not good enough. It's not cutting it, you know. So being here and winning today, especially today, was a tough fight. Those guys, they were riding very good. I mean, second moto, I was pushing. I was doing some good lap times, and Fastiotti was right behind me, so
yeah.
It's fun, you know, to see they trying to push and get to meet and stuff, so I think it's going to be fun. And they are pretty pretty nice guys, and they talk to you on the gate and stuff like this. And it's a little bit different than the US, I would say. We don't talk too much over there. But.
Yeah. I always find it interesting, you know, sitting there watching these motos, and especially when there's two riders, you know, two or three riders with just completely different styles and the way they approach the track. And I mean, that second moto, you know, when you compare how you see the track and how, say, Gorky sees the track, I mean, it's about the only thing the same was that you're both riding two-wheel motorcycles, right? Just different lines, you know, bikes sound different. You know, is that the way you've just been since you started riding, just very smooth and thinking your way around?
Yeah, I mean, I was thinking about all this a few months ago, and I think Gorky is from the U.S., and when you go practice, they groom all the tracks, so you can really go wide open and, you know, just go as fast as you can. And in France, when we practiced when we were kids, I mean, if you go fast on a compact track, you'll go nowhere. So you got to actually slow down to kind of get better and better and keep your momentum. So that's why my riding style is completely different. Maybe Canadian guy, you know, in between maybe.
Yeah.
I'm not sure about practice, like track around here, but it looks like the tracks are a little bit different. The US is more, you know, in California where we practice, I mean, it's all groomed.
Yeah.
You go at 9 a.m. and you just go in all the curves and go wide open. So that's what they do. And I mean, today was pretty alpac. In the US, it's very rare to see something like this.
Yeah.
You don't see much dust or anything. Even this weekend in Colorado, they had tons of ruts and stuff like this. So they, I mean, the top guys, they just handle the track.
Even the pits here are dusty. So yeah, you definitely get your fill of dust. But you know, when you're taking you know, say on the sight lap or something like that, is that, you know, do you make a real conscious effort to look for those smooth lines, or is it just kind of something that comes to you once the moto gets going?
It's tough to say. Sometimes you can see a line, but when you race at the speed that you go, this line might not be working at all. So I think I used to not do the pride lap, and today I wasn't even going to do it, but they told us to go in stage before, and I was there, so I was like, why not, you know? But,
yeah.
And then I cut the track on the pride lap on one spot, because I didn't want to look at all on everything, because it just sometimes it doesn't mean anything. You know, you think you're going to go this way, and when you race, you go so fast that you cannot even go this way, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, just gotta adapt with the track, and especially today, actually, all the lines, they after 10-15 minutes, the track changed, and then you gotta go inside and outside. It was pretty challenging.
Well, you know what? It was fun to watch, and congratulations.
Yep.
Next weekend, I think you're on the same playing field, because no one's been to that track before, so
that's good.
It should be good. But Christophe Porcel comes to Canada first time and gets greeted with an overall win in the MX1 class. So it's on to round two in Prince George.